John chapter 4, verse 50 says, "Go," Jesus told him, "your son will live." The man believed what Jesus said to him and departed. Now, in this moment, there's a few things going on. It could be easy to think that Jesus could just look down into the future and go, "Oh, the boy's going to be okay. Don't worry about it. This royal official, you're going to be fine." However, we're going to see in the next few verses that the royal official is going to find out that the exact timing was when Jesus said this. But also, John divinely gives credit to Jesus for doing it. Verse 54 says, "Now, this was also the second sign that Jesus performed." So Jesus did the action. Had not Jesus intervened, the boy probably would have died. And yet Jesus said, "No, you're going to live." And what's most significant is this royal official believed. And that's what John is doing. The woman at the well believed. People of Samaria believed. This royal official believed. John is trying to make a point that Jesus is who he says he is. And if we believe that, we get the right to become children of God. That's in chapter 1. That's in his point at the end of the book. He said, look, this man believed. And there's a sign here. Not only is the sign that this boy was healed, the sign was that this royal official, this government official, was desperate, went to Christ, and said, "Please help my boy. I've got no power of my own. No ability, no answers, no solutions. Only you, Jesus, can do this miraculous thing." And then Jesus says, "Your boy will live," and that's it. And the guy doesn't demand anything else. He believed that Jesus was exactly right, telling the truth. That's a miracle in and of itself, especially when you think of powerful government officials who usually put their hope in themselves. This man put his hope in Christ. And Jesus does this miracle, and John shares it with us so that we too may believe, see a miracle in our own life, and be adopted into the family of God.